Don't know why I act the way I do. Like I ain't got a single thing to lose. Sometimes I'm my own worst enemy. I guess that's just the cowboy in me.
Well, it is 7 degrees below zero. Truck was not plugged in. Oh, that says -4. Engine temperature is at zero. See how much she hates this. No block heater, no grid heater, no glow plugs. There she is. Oh, damn. Well, always seek adventure, signing in. It is 0 degrees out right now. Here in Middle Tennessee, guys, it's fucking cold out there. See my truck? And yeah, I'm hanging out in my camper right now because it's fucking nice and warm in here. That's fire going in the house, but I went to go start the truck, as you can see in the beginning of this video, that, well, it started all right. It started fine. But my lift pump is froze up a little bit, and it's, I think, just my fuel's gelled up. I have heat in there right now, but I don't trust that shit that much. I don't think it fucking works. Obviously, it doesn't fucking work. So, but I got her plugged in now. I didn't plug it in last night. I haven't been to work all week. It is Wednesday, guys. You know, I'm fucking, the wife actually, I took the wife to work in the Buick because the roads are still pretty bad. But I was going to take my old fifth wheel. And I was going to take my old fifth wheel that I had in my pickup truck, because I don't have a fifth wheel camper no more. I was going to take it to a guy in Sweetwater. He was going to give me like $800 for it if I delivered it. And I was like, all right, cool. Then he called me up and he's like, hey, is that the kind that's recessed, or is it above the deck of the bed? I was like, it's recessed. He's like, shit, that one won't work for me. Sorry, bud. He's like, you didn't leave yet. I was like, well, I'm taking my wife to work. And I got the fifth wheel with me. He's like, well, I apologize. I can't use that. I was like, all right, well, never mind. No harm, no foul. But the truck started, and it ran, and it idled, and then it fucking fizzled out. It died. It said, fuck you. It's weird because it'll fire right back up, but then it dies. So I'm feeling like maybe it's, I don't know. It's fucking cold out. That's probably what it is. But I'm out here in the camper. I don't really winterize my campers, even though this one here I kind of half-ass winterized. I drained the water heater, which is down there on the outside. I drained the water heater, pulled the plug on that, drained it, even though there's antifreeze in the whole system. See, the guy that had this before me, for some reason, see, I never winterize my campers. I just keep them with the heat going all winter long. You know, I got my 100-pound propane tank right there, and I leave it on low, on like the lowest setting. About 60 in here is as low as this one goes, and the camper stays, you know, stays warm all winter long, and that's fine, no big deal. But this guy put RV antifreeze in the freshwater tank, so that's kind of weird. I actually didn't realize that, and so me and Angel were out on a camping trip with this thing, and all the lines still had a residual amount of antifreeze in it, and I had no clue. I bought this thing in the middle of, you know, in the end of summer, so, and it was winterized. So I was like, me and Angel were making ice in the camper, and because we have a little ice machine, and both her and I got pretty sick. We were really bad headaches, and we thought it was like we sent it too hard with the liquor, but that is not the case. We are lucky that it was just a very small amount, but we got sick that was Thanksgiving weekend when we were at the KOA in Crossville. Yeah, we did not, we got sick. We didn't feel good for about a day. We drank a lot of water, a lot of water from jugs, and went from there, and we felt better. But I don't understand the whole, just drain the fresh water tank, you know? Why bother? I don't know. I just drain everything, and I leave the faucets open if that's going to be the case. Like, I had the faucets all open. Everything's open in here. You know, the water pump is, it's still got, you can see when it fucking runs, that there's, it's pink. So, oh well. But, I'm actually in the camper because I got a Samsung TV in the camper, and, I got Lord of War. I don't have that in the house. So I'm gonna watch Lord of War out here for the time being, and hang out in the camper because it's cozy out here. It's warm, you know. I got the heat running, so I'm gonna watch Lord of War. It's one of my favorite Nicolas Cage movies. Really can't wait to get this thing out for the summer. It's gonna be really fucking nice. I can't wait. We got a trip coming up for Gatlinburg, February 8th ish, and that is our first trip of the year. And then we have Salt Lick Campground up in just by the Kentucky border. That's on the Cumberland River. Got that. We got quite a few trips. We got our big trip scheduled this year for actually May, when I usually go for our anniversary, because Angel does not get vacation in May. She gets mandatory vacation in June. At the end of June. So we are going in the end of June to Grand Isle, Louisiana with this thing. And I am in the market for a new side-by-side. It's time. I want to get a new one again. We did what we had to do, and shit's back to normal. So we's gonna get a side-by-side. I think I said that in another video that I did not post. I don't think I posted that video. I'll have to post it before this one. But yeah, I'm looking forward to our trips. It's going to be fun. It's going to be a hoot. I have started a diet. I was up to 369 pounds. Guys, I am a fat fuck. I am now down to 347. I have lost some decent weight. We all know I was once 450 pounds at one point. And I got down to 263 because I had weight loss surgery, but right after weight loss surgery, after I hit my goal was 263, I felt good, I was running every day, I was still losing weight. I was very active, but after my, I got to 263, I had my truck wreck, and I was in the hospital, and I had surgery after surgery. We had to downsize. We moved into the camper. You guys all know that. And, I hit a depression for a while there because I was in so much pain with my bicep and my shoulder. I was on painkillers all the time. I was drinking liquor all day long. Guys, it was a bad, dark point of my life. You know, and, I add a lot of the stuff, the whole nomadic trolling to that. You know, I was in a bad state of mind when I was there, that's why I don't, now I'm in a really good state of mind with myself right now. I'm where I'm at in my life other than with my health, but I'm getting better. It is moving in the right direction. So, you know, I'm eating healthier. I'm eating less. Actually, you can see I got these seasonings out. What am I going to do with those seasonings? I am making a deer tenderloin for dinner tonight. I'm sous-viding it, and then I'm going to smoke it. So that's all I eat now, guys. I eat deer meat. I eat super clean deer meat, which is very lean. I don't do diets. I just watch what I eat. I'm no longer eating fast food anymore, which really, believe it or not, wasn't a big thing for me before either. Except for when I was on the road every now and then, you know, the gas station biscuit, you know, or going out to eat, you know, like Cracker Barrel or something like that. You know, I usually make steaks and, you know, burgers at home, you know, all handmade stuff, you know, none of this pre-made bullshit, you know. But I'm feeling good. And here I am. I'm living life in the fucking camper right now. Wish my wife was with me at the moment, but I think we're going to camp out here this weekend. It's going to get really nice out next week in the 60s. So we go from being 7 below 0 last night to being in the 60s next week or the week after. So, alrighty guys, just a little life update. Fucking out here in fucking shorts. My legs are fucking thin. I don't know if you guys noticed that. Like, my legs are usually super swollen. But since I've lost this weight, my legs, the swelling has gone down too. So that makes me feel a lot better. So, yeah, guys, stay tuned this summer. We are going to be doing a lot of trips. Yeah, we're going to be fucking doing it. So, hope we seek adventure. Signing out, guys.